So, as I was saying before the line went off, so there was no justification whatever for them to hand him over to Nigerian security agents that came to pick him. So, having the arrest, he's now here in Nigeria today. So face the trial according to the trial. We expected that in the meantime we're going to panel a sophisticated legal thing that will be part of this process. So, and I have no doubt about it. They will do job, collectively do justice to whatever charge I file against him or the existing charge. So coming to his present state of health, we have made public that when he was in Kenya, when he was kidnapped in Kenya, he was subjected to inhuman treatment. He was beaten, subjected to torture. He was tortured. And on account of those horrible experience, he took ill, was sick. So before he was brought to this country, before brought to Nigeria. So, but we are doing everything humanly possible to ensure he gets best of medical attention. We are written to the authority, detaining him, and he's improving. His health is improving as I speak to you. He's improving. So, and there's no cause for alarm. I can assure you there's no cause for alarm. Only that by virtue of being in a confinement where he has no access to his brothers, his sisters, the relatives, the cousins, and even the wife, more important, the wife, you effectively classifies him as being subjected to mental torture. That was where some people got that explanation wrong. I never mentioned the cause of my address that he was being tortured by SSS here. I never said that. I was never mentioned in my address that I was being beaten by SSS here. I gave graphic explanation of what happened, what took place in Kenya. I was beaten there based on account he gave me, direct account he gave me. So, but I emphasize on the fact that by virtue of the fact that he's here alone, he don't have, he doesn't have free access to the wife, to the children, to the brothers and sisters, to cousins. So, and except us that can visit him, he's still experiencing a level of mental torture. That's what I'm trying to explain so that people cannot get it wrong from any quarter. So, and we are doing all we can to ensure that he transferred to appropriate custodian where he's supposed to be, pending when application for his bail is revisited and the trial commences. So, and we're in high spirit that Nnamdi Kanu will leave, will come out freely. I can assure you of that. He'll be out. There's no cause for alarm. He'll be out, and I'm not talking about bail. Even if he's granted bail, the charge will be discharged. Whatever charge I find this time around, we dealt with on the merits and get it out in court. So there's no cause to panic. I can assure you that by legal team, the team we are going to empower, we're going to work with us, are very, very formidable in their own, and we're going to do justice to this case. Thank you.
So, you've talked about his health, that is in good shape. Biafran shouldn't panic about his health. What do you think will be the minds of Biafran regards to 26th, the day that he's going to appear in court?
I didn't say the health is in a perfect state or whatever. I said the health is improving health-wise, and it's improving health-wise. That's what I'm saying. It's not that it's wonderful, but it's improving health-wise. We are making effort to see we get as far that we examine him. We've already informed the authority detaining him, and we're taking steps to that effect. So we have formally informed the authority detaining him. So, but improving health-wise, and there's no cause for alarm. We are doing all we can within the confines of law to ensure that the needful are done in court. And we're prepared to go all hot with the government, in this case in court. My advice to the Biafrans, the Abner Biafrans, is to remain calm. Pray for him, pray for us too. Particularly me, who is under serious threat. The first of what happened to me in situations, how I narrowly, by act of providence, to escape being assassinated, is there in the public domain. But I had earlier mentioned and said there's no amount of intimidation or threat of any kind that will stop me from defending the land can help you be. That is settled. And I can assure you that once that divine grace upon me, nobody can kill me. No matter how fortified you are, you can't kill me, because I'm a child of destiny, and I am on the divine mission in this project, in this case. So I am not the one appointed myself. God appointed me to be his lawyer and also to be lawyer for IPOB. I am not doing it out of my own strength. God has been there for me. So, and I advise those who are doing all they can to get me out of the way, to stop thinking evil against me, because whatever evil they think can never see the light of the day. And nothing will stop me from defending him. I will be there with him till the end. I will be there with him till the victory is achieved. I can bet my life for that. Thank you.
So 26 is very, very, very on the road. It's approaching, and Biafrans will know what will be their step and reaction towards 26th. What do you think that will be the way forward for Biafrans, those at home and those abroad, regarding to his appearance in court on 26th?
Nothing extraordinary will happen on 26th. I can assure you that. Only that we're going to be in court as usual and entertain some applications we tend to file before then. I may not be able to mention it at this stage. So, if there is any form of amendment to the charge you have before him, then we take it off from there. But as I speak to you, nothing has been done. So we still believe that what we have before him is the charge, 3-count charge pending against him in court. So nothing much will happen. Also, we have an application too before the court, which has been overdue for hearing. This application needs to be explained, to be heard on that day, because that application in substance is giving an account of what happened in his house on 14th of September. So we have demonstrated